Assalamualaikum. A very good morning to one and all. Today I am back with our English class. We have done so many chapters, so many lessons, so many stories, and many grammar topics, isn't it? Do you all remember all the grammar topics we have done? Yes? If you all don't, please go back to all the videos and watch them carefully. Today I am back with a new topic. We are going to start a fresh new topic, and the topic is of grammar. Before I start, let me tell you all, I have something very exciting for you all. Do you all know what it is? Yes, it is a beautiful story. You all like to hear to a story or see a story? Yes, you all read story books? No, if you all don't read, some might be listening stories from your grandmother or your mother or your father, or let it be any of them from our family. We all like or love to listen to a story. Today I am here with a very beautiful story. So before we start a new topic, let's see that story, and you must watch that story carefully so you will be able to answer all my questions. Yes, let's see it together.
It was 5 in the morning when everyone was fast asleep. The cock was crowing. After some time, he spoke to himself. Why haven't my friends woken up? Then he saw a bee coming towards himself. He said, I saw your friends. They are yet asleep. After listening to the bee, the rooster crowed again. And now finally, all his friends woke up and started coming towards him. The baby bear complained. We want to sleep. We don't want to wake up early morning. The mama bear told, we are huge animals. We need to sleep for a long time. After listening to the whole conversation, the wise monkey replied to everyone, early to bed, early to rise, makes one healthy, wealthy, and wise.
So, did you all enjoy the story? And hope you all have understood and listened to the story very carefully. So, now can you all tell me, who all were there in the story? Can anybody tell me? The very first character in the story, who was it? Yes, it was the cock. Then the second one, who was the second one? The bee, alright. Then, who was it? Baby bear. Then came the mama bear. And the last one was the monkey. Now, we all know these were the characters in the story. So, you know these were the characters in the story. As you remember, cock, bee, baby bear, mama bear, and the monkey are the characters in the stories. You all might be remembering that what did the cock do? What was the cock doing? Yes, cock was crowing. Yes. And next comes the bee. What did the bee do? Do you remember what did the bee do? Yes, the bee came and bee was talking to the cock. Yes, bee was talking to the cock. But do you remember what did the bee say? Can anybody tell me what did the bee say? So now can anybody tell me what did the bee say? Yes, do you all remember? Have you heard the story carefully? Yes, I can see, I can hear some children say, what did the bee say? Yes, the bee said, yes, it is correct. Is it correct that the bee said, comma, what did the bee say? I saw your friends. They are yet asleep. What did the bee say? I saw your friends. They are yet asleep. Yes? Now you can see I have put a comma over here. When we put this comma, we know we have to take a small pause. I saw your friends. They are yet asleep. This sentence was said by the bee. Now we know this sentence has been said by the bee. So pay attention and see what am I doing with the sentence. Now, can anybody guess why have I put these two things over here? Why have I added this to the sentence? Yes, can anybody guess? No, you don't know because we have not done this. These two commas are called as speech marks. What are they called as? Speech marks. Yes, they are called as speech marks. From this word speech, what do you come to know? What speech? Can anybody tell me? Yes, speech means talking. Yes, it is about talking. So we know that I saw your friends are yet asleep was said by the bee. Bee was talking, isn't it? If he doesn't talk, how will he say? So we know the sentence is said when the bee is talking. So the sentence when it is said by somebody and we are telling that same sentence, exact sentence to somebody else, it will come under these two marks, and these two marks are called as speech marks. What are they called as? Speech marks. Y'all can go back to the story and see the bee had said exactly the same thing. I saw your friends. They are yet asleep. Yes? When I am telling you that I saw your friends, the bee said, I saw your friend, they are yet asleep. I am telling you what the bee said. Yes? So when we are telling something to one other person, what the other person had said, it will come under the speech marks. Yes? Moving forward, let's see the next character in the story. Who was the next character? Can anybody tell me? Yes, it was the baby bear. Was the baby bear. Now, I want to write what the baby bear has said. Can anybody guess what had the baby bear said? Do you all remember? Yes, the baby bear had not said anything. What did he do? Yes, baby bear had complained. What did he do? He had complained. So here it is written said. But when the baby bear is complaining, can I write the said word over here? Can I do it? No, I have to write exactly what is there in the story. So we know the baby bear didn't say. He was complaining. So I will not write the word said. I will write the word complained. Yes, the baby bear Complained. What did he complain? Can anybody tell me what did he complain? Can anybody tell me? Can you recollect? Why did the baby bear complain? Yes, my children are very smart and they have heard the story very carefully. The baby bear complained. We want to sleep. Yes, we want to sleep. Is this the sentence complete? This is only one complaint which the bear had complained about. There was one more. What did he say more? What did he say? Can anybody tell me? We don't want to. We don't want to get up early. Yes. So these were the two complaints from the baby bear. We want to sleep. We don't want to wake up early. Now I am telling you what did the baby bear said. So what am I going to do with the sentence? Yes, you are right. I will put the speech mark from where the bear has said. Yes. So now we are very clear with it. When we are talking about somebody what they had said, we will put the sentence into the speech mark. Yes, that sentence will come under the speech mark. Let's move to our next character. So now you have understood what is speech mark. We put speech marks where we are talking about somebody telling you something. Yes, the sentence said by someone we put under the speech marks. Yes. Now let's see one example of it. What's wrong?
Increment.
This is a sentence. What's wrong? Said mom. From this sentence, there are so many punctuation marks. We have done punctuation marks. There is a question mark. There is a full stop. Isn't it? These all are called punctuation marks. Full stop. Question mark. Exclamation mark, comma, these all are punctuations. In this sentence, there are two punctuations, question mark and a full stop. Now, from this sentence, what can we see? What's wrong? These were the words said, but by who? Who said these words? Yes, mom said these words. Yes? So we know that mom had said these words. What will we do with this sentence? Yes, we are going to use speech marks. But where are we going to use the speech marks? Can anybody tell me where are we going to use the speech marks? Yes? Yes. What's wrong? These were the words told by the mother. Yes? These two words will come under the speech marks. So this thing will come under the speech mark. What's wrong? Said mom. So we know that these words were said by mom. That's why they are coming under the speech mark. Let's see one more example now. So the next sentence says, we have got a puncture, said dad. Who is saying over here? Yes. Dad is saying. What did the dad say? We have got a puncture. This was a sentence said by dad. Yes, in this sentence we have an exclamation mark. That is called as a punctuation. Now we know that this sentence is said by dad. What are we going to do with this sentence? Can anybody guess? Yes, when we are talking about somebody saying some sentence or something, we put that sentence under the speech mark. Yes? So this thing, we have got a puncture, is said by dad. That is why it is going to come under the speech mark. So the last sentence for the day. The sentence says, Rita said we will meet tomorrow. So what is being said over here? Can anybody tell me? Yes, you are right. We will meet tomorrow. This is the sentence which is said by Rita. So what are we going to do with this sentence? Yes, when we know that the sentence has been spoken by somebody, we put that sentence under the speech mark. Yes, we will meet tomorrow. This was the sentence said by Rita, and that is why it is under the speech mark. Now we are very clear when we have to use the speech mark. Now I am going to send a small activity from your textbook. You will complete it very neatly and send me a clear picture of it. We will meet in our next class. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.